Yo guys, what is up and welcome back to the channel. I hope all of you have had an amazing day so far. So right now, we're gonna check out the brand new community update because they went ahead and spoke about the new public test build as well as some other stuff. So overall, it should be a pretty interesting video. And also to note, this is the first time ever a community update came out on a Monday or a Tuesday. Really interesting stuff. But anyway, starting it off over here, they went ahead and said, we do have the public test build coming up though, which means most of those maps and new weapons will be available to try out over there. They're talking about the brand new assault rifle being the Peacekeeper, as well as the new SMG, which is obviously the MP7, and also the brand new maps being a remake of Nuketown, obviously also the Christmas raid map also returning. However, as per usual, we won't start confirming and publicly sharing information on those new maps, modes, or whatever else is in the public test build until our usual time when we start officially posting about it here on our social channels. We just like to look at it as everyone in the public test build will get a sneak peek. Continuing over here, they say public test build. To follow up on our last two sparse messages about this, barring any unforeseen issues, the public test build will be releasing later this week. So it is indeed still coming this week. We'll put out a separate post in several communities to share out all of that usual information, like how to download, some common troubleshooting for downloading issues, and what you can expect to find in the build. Awesome stuff. So it is still coming later on this week. Moving on, just a reminder in advance, but these builds are intended to help stabilize the upcoming release by identifying and eradicating bugs in advance. Of course, we have teams dedicated to finding these issues, but there is no equivalent to having tens of thousands of players jump in and start interacting with the new features, changes, UI, or content. So obviously, guys, we're playing the beta to find issues and then go ahead and report them. So obviously, if you encounter a bug or any type of issues, go ahead and report it in game so they can go ahead and deal with all those problems as soon as possible. But moving on some more, keep an eye out for a post on that later this week, and thanks for all of the excitement. We know most of you probably just want to see new content, but at the same time, we greatly appreciate anyone who takes the time to fill out the in-game survey or anything that helps with the test. So awesome stuff, guys. That's all we currently know about the beta. Like they say over here, the main goal is to find issues and go ahead and deal with them before it actually does launch globally for everyone. Moving on some more, guys. War_TVT commented the following: is diamond camo coming in season 13, or do we still have to wait longer? Kadem responded and said the following: yes, we'll see if we can grab some shots of it to share in our next community update. So diamond is coming in season 13. Great news. Super excited to see how that's gonna look, and we will be finding out about that some more in our next community update. Moving on some more, guys. Over here, Mashdroid said the following: hey, I've been enjoying the season a lot and I can't wait for the test server to go live. I have two questions, if you mind answering. Will Alcatraz be available to be played on season 13? And could you please debunk the rumors going on about the change of the game engine from Unity 2016 to Unity 2019? Kadem responded and said the following: Alcatraz in season 13? Probably not. That sucks. I'm so upset about that. I love Alcatraz. Or at least only in a limited capacity. The general interest for that map hasn't consistently been there this season, so we think it'll likely feel better if we make it into a frequent but limited time mode, probably something like the 20v20 is. But damn, I love Alcatraz so much, that kind of does suck. They got to say engine changes. We're afraid we don't have any information to share or comments on in relation to the game engine. So pretty interesting stuff. Moving on some more, guys. Over here, a user said the following: "Congratulations, guys. They really work hard every day to make the game a marvel. Keep it up. I would like to know a few things. Could you give us a little clue about the main theme of Season 13 other than Christmas? I like that they have implemented characters from the Black Ops saga, such as Outrider, Battery, Nomad, etc. But will they include characters from the Black Ops campaign in Season 13, like Alex Mason, Frank Woods, Adler, Hudson? And could you tell us a little hint about the next battle pass? I know it is very early, even if the track is very small, with a single word beforehand. Thank you very much." Cardem said the following: "Hey, yeah, thanks for the support and appreciation for all of this craziness that is pumping out a new season every single month for a whole year. Haha. Well, if you can't tell from all of our map teasers so far, the theme may or may be winter related. Obviously, so far, we've had a lot of snow stuff. Obviously, we have the BO4 remake of Nuketown, which is filled with snow, as well as we're also going to get Raid Christmas or Raid Snow, which has snow. So it's pretty much like a winter snowy theme. Obviously, because we are going into Christmas and it's winter right now and it's cold, so it all does make sense. To your second questions, we do already have Frank Woods in the game, and yes, there are some more coming in this next battle pass, actually. Which also kind of answers your third question about giving a BP hint, haha. Just to add one more, that new assault rifle we teased above is going to have a free and paid version in the BP. Now, the assault rifle is obviously the Peacekeeper, so we're going to have the Peacekeeper in the battle pass, as well as we can see over here, there is going to be some iconic Black Ops soldiers as well in this upcoming battle pass. And then the other new gun is the MP7. We don't know the name of it yet for mobile, but that's probably going to be in a challenge as well as a lucky draw. So pretty cool stuff. But anyways, that is all I wanted to talk about in this video. We have Diamond Camo coming soon. We also have the two new guns. We have some teasers regarding like what's coming in the battle pass. It's just some exciting news, and the beta is just around the corner. Really pumped for that. Now, I'm gonna end the video off here for myself, but I am gonna have all the bug fixes and everything related around bugs pop up on the screen right now for the remaining of this video. So if you are interested in that, then stay and enjoy. But for now, that's all from me. Thank you for watching, and Squally out. Cheers.